It's beginning to look a lot like carnage. Everywhere you go, corpses in the store. But the goriest sights to see are the killers that will be kicking down your door. Thanks for putting up with that. The countdown to Christmas is well underway, and most of the 12 days are already behind us. And I'm sure many of you are already in the spirit of the season. However, I am sure that an equal measure of folks watching this wish it was still Halloween. Nothing is more painful than a toothless Christmas movie marathon when you'd rather be watching some beasts sink their pearly whites into a hapless victim. Yes, we've seen Elf 1 million times already, Janet. No, don't put on the Hallmark Channel. Oh good, you found the Love Actually DVD. I thought I hid that better. While some of the Christmas classics are arguably pretty scary in their own right, I'm looking at you, Home Alone and the Santa Claus, they don't quite scratch the same itch as a mistletoe murder party. So if you're tired of Uncle Greg telling everyone that Die Hard is a Christmas movie for the 10th year straight, take a look at some of these holiday horrors we've collected today. Hello horror heads, and welcome back to the scariest channel on YouTube, Top 5 Scary Videos. I'm your holly jolly horror host, Keegan Hughes, and today we're taking a look at the top 5 scariest Christmas horror movies you need to watch. Deck your halls with disembowelment and trim the tree with some barbed wire, because we're about to get into it. Make sure to give this video a big festive thumbs up and subscribe for more wintertime terror. Let's go. Starting us off at number 5, Black Christmas, 1974. Ignore the remakes, this is the OG classic. Full disclosure, I haven't seen the new Blumhouse one that came out on Friday the 13th, but I do plan on seeing it over the holidays. But back to discussing the retro gem that is Bob Clark's rendition of Black Christmas. Interestingly enough, Clark went on to make A Christmas Story, which is disturbing in its own odd way. This is what some consider to be the original slasher flick. Yes, Psycho came before it, and yes, Texas Chainsaw came out earlier than that. I watched Joe Bob Briggs too. But for the sake of conversation and Canadian heritage, I like to think of this as the prototypical slasher. It's got one of the scariest endings too. Don't worry though, I won't spoil it too much, even if it did debut almost 50 years ago. This Toronto shot Christmas creep show is an absolute blast to this day, and has some moments that remain taut and disturbing in ways that most modern horror has given up on trying. This is a flick that starts strong and keeps the creeps coming. We follow a group of sorority sisters as they get picked off one by one by a mysterious maniac over the Christmas break. There's lots going on that the audience is privy to that the characters never find out about, making this a smorgasbord of dramatic irony with moments where you just want to scream, "Don't go in there!" Plus, many interpersonal conflicts between non-murderous folk make it so that they never really suspect that there's a real maniac on the loose. An unmonitored maniac is a dangerous maniac. The method to the killer's madness isn't discovered until too late, and let's just say the cops are largely confused and useless in this flick. This is a classic for a reason, with some chilling deaths and great camera work, especially considering that this came before the advent of the Steadicam. Death by plastic strangulation, corpses left to rot in the attic, stabbing with a glass unicorn. Oh yeah. Love the festive spirit throughout as well. We got cozy sweaters, twinkling lights, carolers singing, drowning out a murder. Watch out for Barb, alright? She's my holiday inspiration. Getting blackout drunk on dark liquor, messing with the cops, yelling at people over the phone. What a woman. If you're in the mood for some 70s film grain to go along with your evil eggnog, give Black Christmas a go, and tell Billy Merry Christmas, would ya? Coming in at number 4, Gremlins. Another timeless classic right here, this creature feature is equal parts creepy, violent, festive, and fun. Any movie with mass murder in the town square is enough to pull me right in. Of course, many folks out there will claim that Gremlins isn't scary, it's not R-rated, this is for kids, and to that I say, relax. Gremlins is incredible. The story goes like this. A traveling salesman dad snags an unknown creature from an old Chinatown antique store and gives it to his son for Christmas. This little cutie comes with some rules, and of course these rules are broken. And what happens when the rules are broken? Terrifying gremlins pop out and begin their reign of terror. And what a reign of terror it is. Like, dozens of people are injured and even die. They literally fire an old lady at top speed out of her house via malfunctioning stairlift. The carnage is unmatched in other PG movies. The Mogwai and Gremlins are phenomenal mascots, done up in top-notch practical effects of years gone by. Stripe is especially terrifying, especially in that fountain scene. Would not want to walk in on that. I think back to my first time watching Gremlins and remember a scene that particularly disturbed me with, surprisingly, no monsters. Nope, it was Kate's haunting tale of Christmas past that really gave me goosebumps. I would say spoilers, but it has nothing to do with like the story itself, and I feel like this has been covered pretty widely. When Kate and Billy are hiding from the Gremlins, she reveals that when she was younger, her dad had snapped his neck in an attempt to come down the chimney as Santa Claus. She and her mom didn't realize until days later when the smell alerted to them what they had previously thought was a dead cat. Nope, not Little Tiger, but instead a rigor mortis ridden dad, still in full Santa garb. Talk about claustrophobia. I'm getting cold for Christmas, aren't I? Filling out our number three spot, Silent Night, Deadly Night. Speaking of claustrophobia, here is a flick that stirred up some serious claustroversy back when it was released. Okay, I'm sorry, controversy. Silent Night, Deadly Night tells the story of poor Billy, a young lad whose grandpa warns him to be wary of Santa while on his deathbed. After grandpa's parting words left Billy less than willing to embrace Saint Nick, his parents are killed by a man dressed Santa right before his eyes. Years later, after growing up in a Catholic orphanage run by an abusive nun, Billy is forced to dress up as Santa for the department store he works at. He walks in on a coworker he's got a crush on being assaulted and absolutely loses it. And I mean, loses it. Department store Christmas massacre, orchestrated by a Santa-fearing man in a red suit. Love that concept. There are just so many ways to creatively kill people with the stuff you find at the bay. You guys ever do that? Walk through the bay and just think about how you'd murder everyone? No? It's just... Of course, wholesome families hated this concept and rallied for it to be removed from theaters immediately. Their Coca-Cola mascot Santa could not be sullied by this disgusting film industry. Interestingly enough, the director Charles E. Sellier Jr. was uncomfortable with shooting death scenes, causing editor Michael Spence to step up as co-director. Let the fact that the director was uncomfortable with some of the kills speak for how gloriously gory and fun this movie really is. A legendarily bad sequel was produced as well, reusing a shocking amount of footage from the first movie to frame the story. But hey, people get bloodthirsty around Christmas, what can I say? Coming in at number two, Krampus. For personal reasons, I must tell you that this movie is cursed. Do not speak the Krampus's name in vain, lest you fall under his spell as well. Upon seeing this movie in theaters on opening night, my roommates and I ran straight into a terrible streak of bad luck, and the only explanation we could muster was that Krampus had deemed us naughty. Not nice. But that is a story for another day. For now, we'll discuss why Krampus is such a freaky and fun mythic movie. It brings us into the home of a dysfunctional family at Christmas time, the wimpy, city slicker liberal family reluctantly hosting their boorish, hick, conservative relatives. Of course it goes sideways, causing young Max to lose his Christmas spirit. And what happens when the Christmas spirit is lost? Krampus comes to punish you. Directed by Michael Dougherty, the man behind the ultimate tribute to Halloween, Trick or Treat, this spine-tingling romp has some truly excellent merrymaking monsters. There's one I like to call the Maw, and if you've seen it, you'll know why. The monsters are definitely a highlight. Equal measure is creepy and Christmassy, and the Krampus himself is revealed in the perfect way. The whole thing takes place in a blizzard too, instilling the movie with a chilly, isolated feel. And while I wouldn't wish any of these painful deaths on my worst enemies, the characters are written to be unlikable enough that you definitely gain a sense of morbid satisfaction when they go down. And the cast is actually really good, like some big names for a holiday themed horror for sure. We got Toni Collette, Adam Scott, David Koechner, and Alison Tolman, and they play their parts very well. Fantastical Christmas horror is just one of those genres with endless possibilities, so hopefully we see some more of these, huh? More icicle impalements and candy cane clubbings. Stockings stuffed with human entrails. What's the coolest Christmas themed death that you can come up with? And finally, in our number one spot, we've got Rare Exports. The Finns know how to get down with Christmas, no doubt. After all, their folklore shaped who Santa is today. Thankfully, our idea of old Saint Nick is a little different than what's presented in this film. We fly into Finland and see a research team drilling for samples atop a mountain, who then stumble across an ancient burial mound. They excavate using explosives and discover something truly disturbing. They excavate using explosives and uncover something truly disturbing. Hundreds of violent elves scampering around and the original Santa Claus, giant horns and all, trapped in a block of ice. This Santa is not the holly, jolly, chubby man we're used to though. He is a monolithic, child-eating beast. Jalmarian Juuso Hellander directed this film, wanting it to be a black comedy with some horror elements. They played the whole movie straight though, so there's no fourth wall breaking or nods to the audience, which actually makes it surprisingly tense and believable. Plus, it shatters our conceptions of Santa Claus entirely, replacing the magical myth with an unsettling explanation with roots in reality. Ever wonder how Santa does it all? Rare Exports explains it pretty thoroughly. Be careful not to curse, drink, or act in any other way that would put you on the naughty list, because if you do, you are getting a visit from the big man or one of his many elves, and they're not just gonna take your presents. Do these flicks get you in the mood to roast some eyeballs on an open fire? Anyone gonna build a killer snowman? Are there any Christmas horror movies that keep you in the holiday spirit? Let me know in the comments. Speaking of comments, let's see if you folks left any gifts under the last video. 78KRS says, Wolf Cop 2 is much weirder. I mean, as all great sequels are, but there's no avoiding the weirdness of the original. Honestly, I just wanted to talk about wolf dong transformations on screen. Death Buzzard says, eat both White Castle and Taco Bell after drinking beers all night. There's a demon win for you. The thought of that scares me much more than any horror movie. Just make sure to eat your veggies too, okay? Magic says, discuss birds. What kind of birds? I think hummingbirds are neat. You know, peregrine falcons too. Oh, and Birdemic. That's one hell of a flick for sure. Cthulhu Cat says, Deadpool was born in Saskatchewan, the town that rhymes with fun. Saskatchewan? Am I saying it right? Did you know that Detective Pikachu and the Green Lantern were born there too? And Ashley Brown says, they play salad fingers in hell. I'm sure they do more than just play salad fingers, they probably reenact it over and over. Anyone down there is probably well acquainted with Hubert Cumberdale. That's all the time we have for today, folks. Enjoy the holidays, and I'll see you next time.